Let us discuss about the persistent HTTP. Before going to persistent HTTP, let's discuss about some disadvantage in non-persistent connection. So in non-persistent connection, the first disadvantage is like, or we can say shortcoming, is like when new connection is established, means new request from client to the server. So it create or it allocate the TCP buffers and also kept the TCP variable records from both side, as well client side as well as server side. So it create a burden in web server. So which may be increased in case of the serving 100 of the requests from the different client. If many of the client send a 100 of the requests simultaneously to the server, at the server side it have kept buffer, it kept all TCP variable of the connection, so it create a significant burden on the web server side. So second disadvantage is each object, means each requested objects suffer a delay delivery, means 2 RTT, as we seen earlier. First one is for the established TCP connection and second is for the request received and object. So each object suffer a delivery delay. In persistent HTTP, the server leaves the TCP connection open after sending a response, means after sending a response object, it not close the connection, but it open as it is TCP connection. So subsequent HTTP message between same client and server sent over that open connection. For example, that 11 object, 1 HTML file and 10 JPG file. So each of the object not create a particular request or particular TCP connection. So on same TCP connection, it request and response all the objects because the connection is open. The server close the connection only when it is not used or certain configurable amount of the time. After some time, connection will be closed. So it is required little as one round trip time for the all reference objects. So we can say that in persistent connection, performance is improved by 20%. Persistent connection default mode for the HTTP version 1.1. In next video, we will discuss about HTTP messages. Thank you.